Rate of photosynthesis in the plant can be monitored in several ways, but the most important or effective is using an infrared gas analyzer or IRGA. I'll briefly talk about plant physiological data collection using LI-6400 and post data collection steps. Two types of measurement will be briefly covered: survey measurement and CO2 response curve. An ACI curve or assimilation rate plotted against intracellular CO2 concentration can provide a number of insights into biochemistry of a leaf or plant. It is highly useful plant physiological measurement to model future climatic responses. This table is for a brief summary of the comparison of various equipments to measure plant photosynthesis. In this video, we will discuss only LI-6400 module. LI-6800 is the latest equipment to have those measurements. It is also the most expensive one. Photosynthesis is a process by which phototrophs convert light energy into chemical energy. In plants, photosynthesis takes place in chloroplast, which contain chlorophyll. The audience needs to have basic plant physiological knowledge. A small detail can make a big difference. For instance, in most situations, you will use the CO2 mixture. Check small O-ring is in the good condition. Replace it if required, then install the CO2 cartridge so the system can begin pressurizing. A fresh CO2 cartridge is needed each day and will usually last 6 to 8 hours. Matching the IRGAs must be done at the start of a measurement day and routinely during the measurement day. Also match the IRGAs if photosynthesis rates are low, especially for small leaf area. After large CO2 changes, after large flow rate changes, changing ambient temperature. There are several variables that LI-4 can measure: photosynthesis, stomatal conductance, transpiration, and intercellular CO2 are the primary variables. You need to make sure you carry the accessories with you if you are measuring in the field. If you miss any single part, you may not be able to collect data at that time. The basic measurement consists of three steps. Before taking any measurement, it is essential to go through the warm-up step successfully. Here I am showing you how to create a new file. So, in order to create a new file through the measurement menu, it is important to have a unique name, and if needed, you can add a remark at any time. Your remark could be a note that you can have with your data. So, in order to create a new file, you need to go to New Measurement menu, which is F4, and after that, open a log file, type your name, and then type any remark if necessary, and after you are done, hit enter. After your file ready, you can view it, close it. If you press F2, you can see all the environmental conditions. Screen B, C, G gives you many important variables. When you set power out values, you will be able to see light outside. This is the optimum environmental condition requires for measurement. Here I am showing you first leaf measurement. Make sure chemicals are fresh and knobs are in correct position. Your file should be open and IRGA must be ready. There shouldn't be any streak shine on the screen. The power out value should be close to the ambient condition. Here for the demonstration, I am setting it at 1000 micromole of photons per meter square per second. When it gets stable, you are ready to take a measurement. Make sure you select the best leaf or a good reference leaf. As I said before, you need to have a good representative but not damaged, diseased or broken leaf. So I'm going to pick one of the leaf from here just to demonstrate. So I'm clamping this leaf here in the leaf chamber. Okay, now I can see the real-time data in the screen. And wait until you get a stable reading. You can see the reading real-time data in the screen in the form of graph or in the form of values, whatever you way you prefer. And while logging the data or recording the data, you can log or record in two ways. You can use leaf chamber and click from here, or you can click pressing F1, screen menu by pressing F1. This is another video that I am showing leaf photosynthesis measurement. I already clamped the leaf into the leaf chamber and I am looking the data in the screen. And as you can see the number, it is actually going up, and I can use the graphs also to check my data, and it looks like the graph is pretty much stable. It's getting more stable and I'm getting more stable values. So I'm going to log my data. If I press F1, it will record the data. Right now the photosynthesis value is 1.44. As you can see, I just recorded it,
or if I want to record it from here, I can do it as well. If I press it here, it records the data. So for example, I already took two measurements. I wanted to have just only one measurement. I can add remark here and I can say the first data is good or something like that.
It is always important to look real-time data. There are so many variables you might see on the screen. I would go to B, C, G, and E. This is a very important question. You may need to do some literature review to decide which leaf to pick and which state to choose. Second fully expanded leaf in the sounded area is a common practice while selecting a leaf. Diseased, damaged, and broken and young leaves should be avoided. Washing or cleaning leaves before taking measurement can disturb stomata. This may not apply to all species. This is how the output file looks like. This is an auto program for ACI curve or assimilation rate plotted against intercellular CO2 concentration curve. You can make a custom program. A quick note, by contrast with their adaptations, C4 plants are not as limited by carbon dioxide, and under elevated carbon dioxide levels, the growth of C4 plants may not increase as much as C3 plants. In order to download the data, connect the LiCo to the computer using the RS-232 connection on the console and appropriate connection for your computer, that is USB converter or 9-pin port. You need to have a configuration changes in your LiCo. Open the file extension program on the computer. When you see the data and double click it, it will start downloading. You can also wirelessly collect the data in your computer. This is where you can download the LiCo related softwares. All the softwares are free here. You can navigate up and down and find out the software that you need. And there are software for Windows as well as for Mac. This is the software that I used in order to collect the data from LiCo to my computer. And this is how the software looks like. There are three ways you can analyze your ACI curve data. First one is using R software. R Studio is an open and free software to analyze and develop graphical tools of data. The website links to a platform where you can download R code and sample analyze data. The second one is LeapWave website. In this website, you can submit your data and get the results in your email. You will need to process your data according to the requirement. And you can also view recent data, other submission data, graphs. And you can also download those graphs and compare your data. The third one is ACI curve fitting tools by Sarkey et al. This curve requires at least 5 data pairs of A and CI values, including presumed limiting factor. There is an instruction to fit the data and it gives you the output. You can download an Excel sheet. You have to download Excel sheet every time when you have new set of data, and you can easily analyze your data using this template. It gives you lots of values and lots of variables. It has clear instructions. It gives VC max value, which is maximum rate of carboxylation, J max value, which is the maximum rate of electron transport, PTP value, which is the rate of triose phosphate utilization. You can easily change the input section and it will give you the output result with the graphs. Before turning up the equipment, you will need to close the open file. It saves the data. You can also put your equipment in a sleep mode. If you need to have a short break, doing that is helpful. In the description box, I will post a link to all the resources that I have. Thanks for watching.